Greetings and salutations, beautiful people. Today is Friday. Check. Shoot. Today is Friday, January the 4th. Today's vlog is going to be primarily some tips that you can use. If you're a mom, if you have a busy schedule, if you have a lot going on, just to kind of make things a whole lot faster and easier to, you know, kind of maneuver through the day. Tips that I need to lock into my routine every single day. I think what happens for me is like I get thrown off by so much going on that I haven't really locked these things into my weekly regimen. But I know once I can do that, it'll be a breeze. So today we will be focusing on some tips and tricks to make this keto thing a little bit easier. So stay tuned, stay close, stay subscribed, comment down below if there's anything else you want to know. Today is a wild hair day, but we're gonna do what it do, baby. See you guys a little bit later. Peace. Word of advice, when you have time, try to boil your eggs in advance and then put them right back in the carton so that you can use them whenever you're there, whenever you're ready for them, and they're already boiled. Hey guys, I wanted to run down a few of the other products that I use to help me with my keto journey. I have three products for you that I want to go through. The main and most important one is MCT oil. This is MCT oil. It even says supports a ketogenic diet. So I want to tell you that So it's good if you are struggling to get your fats in. I told you want to keep 70% fats, 20% protein, and under 10% carbs. So if you're struggling to get 70% fats, that's a lot of fats that you got to get in. That's a lot of mayonnaise. That's a lot of fatty foods. That's a lot of grease. That's a lot of oil. That's a lot that you're trying to get in. And sometimes we take in too much protein and not enough fat. So that could be harmful too. So this MCT oil is something that will help you get your fats in. For every tablespoon, it's 130 calories, but it's 14 grams of fat. So if you need a quick boost, and it's from 100% coconut oil, it sustains energy. It's clean fat for fuel. It's clean fat for fuel. So if you low on energy, you need something to boost you up. MCT oil. You can blend it with your coffee, your teas and shakes, or you could take it straight. Now, if you take it straight, be prepared to have to go to the bathroom. But MCT oil, this is the first one that I wanted to put you guys up on. And you will see that it's in my today. I added this because I didn't get enough fat in yesterday. So I added this to make sure that I got in my fats today. So MCT oil. I got this from Trader Joe's or ShopRite. I got this from ShopRite. So check it out. The second thing that helps with the keto diet to kind of help you along the keto diet is magnesium supplements. Now, I guess I should put these on my tracker, but I have not been putting them on my tracker. But A lot of people, you know, if you've watched any other YouTube videos, if you have Googled anything about the ketogenic diet, a lot of people talk about keto flu. And it's when your body just feels so weak and everything feels hazy and you just feel like you can't snap out of it to bring yourself to focus. Now, it usually happens within the first 3 days of ketosis. You usually get some leg cramping and different things like that. So the first 3 days, that's pretty much how I was able to determine that I was in ketosis. But something that can combat that, if you're struggling with any of that, magnesium supplements. Now, I still take them even though I'm not battling any of that, because the first time around, I was dying. And I went on Keto Connect YouTube channel, and they recommended magnesium or potassium in your diet to help you along with that. So I picked these up, and I have not had keto flu since then. So magnesium, I have the 500 milligrams. You can go upwards of, I think, 1500, 1000, something like that. But I got these from ShopRite. The last thing for today's video that I want to include to help you guys with your ketogenic lifestyle is protein powder. Now, some of you probably already know about this, but this is light protein, low calorie nutritional protein. This is the vanilla cupcake flavor. 10 grams of protein, no added sugar, 60 calories per scoop. If you're struggling to get your protein in, if you're struggling to get it in early enough in the day, and you want to, you know, get a scoop in, you want to add this to your coffee, you want to make a shake with it, you want to, put it in your baking goods, your brownies, your, anything, you can pretty much add a scoop of this, and this will give you, 10 grams of protein for each scoop, 4 grams of fiber, 1 carb, and 0 grams of fat. So you're not getting any fat with this, but you're getting your protein. So this would be something to get your protein in. What's up, y'all? In my house, this pressure cooker saves lives. So this is my pulled pork. Well, what's left of my pulled pork, because my family went in on the pulled pork.
R. Kelly engaging in sex with an underage girl.
Tongues are really wagging. Ears are really burning because they're like, did you hear about the sex tape? So that means everything else that we've been hearing, we knew it was true.
What's up, guys? I'm on my way to take my son to his grandmother's house, and I just wanted to get on here to get you your view of the R. Kelly Lifetime, Surviving R. Kelly on Lifetime. It's just crazy, right? So let me give you a synopsis. If you haven't seen it, you need to go and watch it. I'm not really giving anything away, but it's basically a group of women who met R. Kelly while they were young in high school, and he was well above the age of consent, and they had intercourse with him, or they had some type of relations with him in some kind of way, leading to these women being... I don't even know a word for it. I guess like sexually violated. Here's my thing, right? And I'm sure some of y'all gonna disagree with me. I'm sure some of y'all gonna be upset with me. But this is my opinion. And if you watch the show, you need to get your own opinion of the situation. So here's my thing. Number one, no matter how many years later, a woman comes out about being violated, she was still violated, and she was still influenced and impacted as a result of these violations. That's number one. Number two, no matter how famous
the violator is, no matter how rich, no matter how famous a violator is, that does not give him to the consent to disrespect and mistreat a woman who, at any age. That's number two. Number three, these women, now everybody had their celebrity crush in high school where they fantasized about meeting them and everything like that, right? These women were given the opportunity to meet him, whether it was in malls or he was coming to their high school or anything like that. They all had the opportunity to meet him. And because they were in that puberty hormonal stage, they linked up with him outside of just meeting him at the mall or meeting him at the high school. Here's my issue. This grown man went to these high schools, went to these malls with the intention of messing with these women. There's no way. There's no way that every time you go into a high school and you're going to meet fans everywhere. You're R. Kelly for crying out loud. You're going to meet fans and people who are excited to see you and people who want to screw you and people who are just head over heels for you everywhere. Everywhere. From high schoolers on up. Why couldn't it be a woman of age? Why couldn't it have been a mutual agreement between two adults and y'all keep it y'all business? And I don't even know what number I'm on, but next number. You were married. When all of this was going down and Andrea Kelly didn't know nothing about it, you were married. So you had an obligation to your wife to come home clean after your performances and your shows. You set up everywhere you went and everywhere you performed, you set up locations to mess with these different women, young women underage. And I don't care how, I was head over heels for Lil Bow Wow. I was head over heels for half the members of B2K. I was head over heels for a bunch of celebrities growing up. And of course, let me not forget this next point. My parents allotted me the opportunity to see some of these celebrities that I was head over heels for in concert, in performance. But never in a day would my parents have allowed me to get caught up with these men at a young age. So I blame the parents too. I blame the parents too. And I think that as a community, see, when you start taking the village, I ain't going to preach on y'all today, but I'm going to give y'all a little bit. When you start taking the village out of the responsibility for raising a community, these kids skipping school and the pedophiles and the wolves, they're out here waiting for kids to be misguided so that they can prey on them and use them for whatever disgusting fetish and practice that they have in their disgusting mind. Now, next point. R. Kelly himself was molested as a child. So this goes back well before he was a performer. This issue in the black community runs deep. It runs as deep as slavery. We saw what white slave owners did to our people, and now we've become a people that sweep it under the rug and we're doing it to each other, and it pisses me off. And we have to do a better job of protecting, providing, and preparing our youth for what is out here, because we ain't doing it yet and our kids are not safe. And let me find out that my son is out here with a woman or whomever 10 years plus his elder, And he doing something he ain't got no business. Oh, yeah. I don't care. Ain't no bribe in the world. Ain't no amount of money in the world. And if the community was on their job, if Aaliyah's community was on their job, if Andrea's community was on their job, if Sparkle was on her, if everybody connected to these celebrities that's out here doing this to these women, and people, it's regular people doing this to these women. If everybody was on their job, if his manager was on his job, if the whole village was on their job, R. Kelly would not have been allowed to do the things that he's done to these women. These men that he had in his corner that he was paying, it shouldn't have been no amount of money in the world for them to allow him to hurt these women in these ways. They should have been knocking his teeth out, every single last one of them, every time they caught him with a woman that wasn't of age or of consent. Because they all knew about it. They all protected him. They all watched him. And it's disgusting. The entire village is sick. The entire village of people who don't do nothing, who don't stick up for kids, who don't do the right thing, regardless of who's watching, is sick. Because trust me, I go to jail for mine. And I'm going to say it straight like that. I will go to jail for all the students that I've taught. I will go to jail for all the parents that I educate. Anything that I invest myself into, know that I'm going to invest myself wholeheartedly. And that's what's wrong with the village. People trying to get a dollar. People trying to get a quarter. And they forget about doing what's right. Not me. Not mine. And I'm going to raise mine to make sure that he respect women, love women, appreciate the beauty in women, and in men, and in himself. Video done made me, this show done made me mad, y'all. And then watching some of the comments on Facebook, I done deleted quite a few people off my Facebook. Because so many of them saying, wasn't y'all in high school going to them high school parties, messing, sleeping with them DJs? It don't make it right. Goes to show that the village is sick. Anybody that's seen these local DJs with some of these young kids should have been knocking their teeth out. The dude, the white dude that pulled the girl at the McDonald's over the counter the other day, those brothers in there should have been knocking his teeth out. And I'm going to say it just like that. Video done got me hot before I go to bed now. But y'all stay blessed, stay close, stay subscribed, because I'm just going to keep giving it to y'all straight every day for the next 15 days. Maybe this frustration will help me lose some more weight, y'all. Ha ha! But y'all like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you guys think about everything. These are my macros listed below. Not quite 70% fat, but I'm close.
Remember, y'all, I have two scales. So get on both scales, and then because they're never the same, and I take the average of both weights.